Okay, well, let's walk up on this little area here, and I'll try and explain some of the psychology behind what I was thinking here. So, if we come like down here, this really gives you a good idea of why I did it this way. So I'm trying to cover the ground. I'm trying to make it to where you can't necessarily see this hardened clay stuff unless you're up close, which is kind of like real life. So in real life, when you look over a field, you can't see the ground. You can only see the grass and stuff. And it's because of this like perspective that you've got on it. And then as the closer you get to it, the more of the ground is revealed and the more of the thing you can see underneath, which in this case would be like clay and stuff. And also lots of coarse dirt and not grass, because I'm trying to make this die off slowly as it gets into this kind of like deserty area over here on the edge. Anyway, my point is there's a lot of thought that's going into this, and so this is subject to change, but this is my iteration so far of a grassy hillside that is inspired by real life. Yeah, definitely heavily inspired by real life. And a couple of the things that I'm talking about here is like the spider webs and stuff. So let me bring you on a little bit of an adventure for a moment. So I'm gonna take a deep breath because I'm just really excited about this project, and I'm gonna get into story mode. So I'll be up. All right, peoples. So we're gonna slap one of these bad boys down because there's some clay and stuff in here, and I found that this helps greatly when doing this kind of a project. So while I do this, I'm gonna work a little bit on this, and I'm gonna kind of expand this area that I've got over here. And while we do it, I'll be walking back and forth and we'll talk about things, and I'll tell you guys a little bit of a story. So sit back, get yourself that tasty beverage. I really like the English breakfast and the Irish breakfast teas when I'm Minecrafting. So get whatever it is that you get and let's get started here. So in real life, I grew up on the coast, kind of in the Puget Sound. I grew up next to the water, and it was very, 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 very cold and windy and miserable a lot of the time. I'm not exaggerating. Like a lot of the time, it was overcast and rainy and miserable, and it's just the way that it is up there in the San Juan Island region. It's because of the Olympic Mountains and the rain shadow and all of the convection currents and the technical jargons. But anyway, the point is that there's one day where I was walking out of town to somewhere else, and I had to go a couple miles, maybe like 4-5 miles total on foot. So a good little walk, and definitely a good little walk on a rainy, blustery, windy day, which it was. I think it was around about probably like in the 30s of the degrees of the factors. So it was definitely not an enjoyable experience to walk along a particular trail that went to my particular destination, which just so happened to be right on the water. So the town is basically sitting on this cliff, kind of like parts of it are sitting on these cliff sides that are right up against the ocean. And so there's these little trails on one part of it that just goes right along the water all the way out of town. And so I was taking this trail one day, and it was all miserable, like I'm talking about, and it was just driving me crazy. My face was cold, my nose hurt. You know when your eyes are watering because it's cold, and like you try, oh man, I just don't even want to get back. It's making my eyes water right now. I hate that. Nature sucks. I'm a vampire. Nature sucks. I'm just kidding. I love nature. It's one of my favorite things. So, hence the reason why I spend so much time recreating it in the virtual worlds. So anyway, man, that really distracted me. That was a profound thought I just had. Back to that later. Anyway, back to the story. So I'm trying to get down this I think it's like, man, I don't even know, like 3-4 miles, something like that, from the start to finish, from in town to out of town where I was headed. And yeah, I was just sick of walking in the blustery wind and rain right up against the ocean. It was spraying up onto the trail and stuff. So I decided to take a cross cut. I decided to take a shortcut. And the shortcut was really good shortcut as far as distance is concerned. Like the amount of time I would save from taking the shortcut was very drastic. However, the route in which I took at the time, had no idea how arduous it would be. Like, bear in mind, I grew up in this town, right? I spent 20 years in a town that's probably 4 miles wide. Not even joking. So I knew this place like the back of my hand. But this was a place that I had never been to. And when I'm not exaggerating, guys. If you guys come from a small town, let me know. I'm sure you'll back me up on this. But you know every single little nook and cranny and freaking back alley and place to be because of the teenage years of freaking running around and ditching school or whatever it is. Man, that I did back in the day to find all these cool places. And I knew about all of them. Like, the whole town was mapped out, like I'm talking about, back of my hand. But this was a place that I had never been. And to kind of give you an idea, it's like, trying to kind of draw it out with my cursor, it's this big arch that goes around this big finger of a mountain that the town's sitting on, kind of this cliffside. And so there's this hill that's kind of similar to this. It's like the equivalent of if I was to be, this is a perfect example. This is the exact shape that it is in real life, actually, a little bit. So if we were here and the trail was just here on this level and we had to walk all the way around this big hill, what I did is I went over the top like this. I went over the top trying to get back to the trail, in this case, which is like the river bed here. So yeah, that's what I did. This is probably a good time to go up there and sleep. Oh man, what I'm talking about, this is a story. I'm liking it. But anyway, I hope you guys are liking it. So I'm taking this crosscut, and I had to climb up this big sandy bank, and it starts to get really thick and forested and stuff. It starts to get brambly. There's like blackberry bushes. Now, in the Pacific Northwest, there really isn't anything in the foliage that's gonna get you. There's no snakes, you know. There's nothing harmful at all. Pretty much the worst thing you could run into is like nettles, which suck, blackberries, thistles, that kind of stuff. And then maybe the one other thing, which is kind of like the punchline of the story, so I'll hold off on telling you about that. Anyway, so I'm traveling through this new area that I've never experienced before, and it's getting to be dark, which is another reason why I took the shortcut, right? It's dark, it's rainy, it's misty, I'm walking, I don't even have a raincoat or whatever, so I'm taking the trees for cover. So the hillside is covered in trees. And so it's even darker than it is outside the trees, which I was not anticipating when I went into them. And so if I could wager a guess, I think the shortcut itself, the amount of distance and linear distance that I would have to travel, maybe a mile at the very most, probably a little less than a mile. But the elevation change and stuff was very drastic. So anyway, I'm just wandering through. I'm having a grand old time. I'm very happy that I was able to get out of the rain and everything like that. And it's warm and everything. And I'm just super happy. And I'm finally relaxed and everything because I was getting a little stressed out. And there's this moment, and I think if any of you guys are theater nerd, I'm not too into it, but I have heard a couple terms, and one of which is the anagnorisis and peripeteia. Please correct me if I'm pronouncing it incorrectly, but it refers to the moment in the hero's journey when the cards align and he comes to terms with his true self, the true nature. It's like when you're driving by an orchard and all the trees look random until right when you get perpendicular to it, all the big words today, guys, then all the things suddenly become ordered and you see the order in the chaos. And that's what happened to me at that particular moment in time. I was able to become aware, I guess you could say, of the order in the chaos of the dark, brambly thickets that I was trudging my way through. So, like any good horror movie, the character doesn't become aware or scared or whatever of the threat until they're inches away from it and it's right behind them, or they're right about to fall in the hole. You know what I'm saying? And then they realize, and so you can get that tension. Well, it was just like that. I think that comes from reality, that type of story comes from reality, because that's how it works in the real life sometimes. So, and that's what happened in this case. So I'm just walking, and I finally realized something. I'm like, you know what? I've never been here. I'm going to take a look around. at the horizon. Like, the whole time I'm doing this, I'm like, ooh, there's bushes, there's a cliff, there's a log. And I'm doing this, like, really, in real life, looking down at my feet. And I kind of look up for a second, because I'm like, where am I actually headed to make sure I'm not going in a circle? And I look up, and the only thing I can see in my entire periphery is spider webs. I'm not even joking. There was a spider web that I was about to walk into. There was a couple that I could, if I walked around that one, I would run into some more. And I was completely 100% surrounded. Now, keep in mind, I'm not a phobia person. I don't have phobias per se. And especially not spiders, or not especially not spiders, but I don't have a specific phobia of spiders. However, I do get a little bit cringy when I get, whoops, that didn't work. I forgot to hit the button. I do get a little cringy when I see a spider walk across my desk or across my leg or something like that. I get a little, that little gaggy, tight chest feeling you get? You know what I'm talking about. And yeah, that kicked in, guys. My flight or fight responses kicked in, and I saw these spider webs, and I kind of focused my eyes. And before I focused my eyes, so here's what's happening. Okay, this is the process that's going on in my head. So I'm looking at all these spider webs, and I'm realizing, okay, let's think about this realistically. Realistically, I know there aren't poisonous spiders that would make these types of webs in the place I'm growing up, because there are a couple of poisonous kinds of spiders. There's the black widow in that area, very rarely. There's also the brown recluse, which is very common, which a couple of my friends have actually been severely, severely injured by those guys. Those guys are super, super dangerous. But all of those spiders are ground dwelling. They don't actually make these giant webs. There's a funnel spider, which is super poisonous. But again, very noticeable webs, super easy to detect and stay away from. Everybody who lives in the area has known about them since they were kids. Not a big deal at all. However, my point is these spider webs were not those kind. They were up high. They were in the bushes. They were in the trees. They were garden variety spiders. The kind of spiders you see in all the magazine pictures, just the classic brown and orange, slightly translucent, big fat butt. You know what I'm talking about, the garden spider. So that's what's going on in my head. I'm like, that's what this is. There's tons of garden spiders all over, and I'm just seeing their little hangout. This little neck of the woods is their little hangout spot. So all I gotta do is just circumnavigate, right? And so that's when it kind of, I'm kind of want to check to make sure I'm right. I want to make sure that they are those kind of spiders. You know what I mean? So I'm kind of looking and trying to find them, and I can't find any of the spiders. All I see is these weird, this brown plant material all over the spider webs, right? I'm not finding the actual individual spiders because I'm looking for these particular shapes and everything. And so I can't see them. And keep in mind, it's dark, right? It's getting very dark. It's dusk at this point. Right about when I'm noticing this, is right about when it's getting to be that golden hour where the sun is just about past, or it's past the golden hour is actually what I'm trying to say. It's right when it's starting to get dark. And so these spider webs are covered in this pine cone stuff, this pulp, this leaf material. And I just am so confused, and I'm getting my face a little bit closer, and I'm looking at this thing from right in front, and I can barely see it. It's the camera lens focused. And all of a sudden, I stopped looking past the webs, and I started looking at the webs. And the little brown pieces of plant material were actually spiders. Little baby spiders. For some reason, it was the mating season, the breeding season, and they had just cracked open a billion freaking little tiny spiders that were infesting these huge webs to the point where I literally thought the webs were covered in fallen leaves or something from some big windstorm that had blown a pine needle bush into the freaking web. Oh, my heart is right now is remembering this, but oh my gosh, I'm so sorry if there's any arachnophobics in the viewing audience. But anyway, so yeah, it was this moment where I realized that all around me there were
baby spiders inches from my body and all of these different areas and up above and down below. And I realized I had almost stepped in one of the webs, and it was a terrifying moment, right? And then it got worse. Then it got worse. So keep in mind, it had been a little dark, and I had been distracted, and it was wet, and I was cold, and I was trying to get home, and it was just miserable, and I wasn't paying attention. However, if I was paying attention, I would have noted that it was like that with the baby spiders for around about the last half mile, and that I wasn't brushing leaves off my shoulders and just general bushes out of my way. I was literally covered from head to toe, hat, legs, arms, in baby freaking spiders. I'm not exact. I mean, it was billions of spiders in my periphery, on my body, just in the area. It was unbelievable and scary and horrible. Oh my God, just thinking about it is making me, like I said, tight-chested. So anyway, what ended up happening, and I'm not done, guys. I'm not even done. It gets worse. I'm not joking you. So in this moment, I'm tearing off my clothes, right? My outer layer of clothes. I'm shaking them. I'm smacking them up against a tree. I'm shaking all these spiders. I had to comb my hair with a pocket comb that I luckily had randomly, which I normally like would never have one, but I randomly had one that day in the certain coat that I was wearing. So I like combed my hair and stuff. It was horrible. I actually climbed up onto a log to get out of the sea of spider webs. I wish I could show you a picture. It was everywhere, and I was surrounded 360 degrees on all sides, as far as I could see, by webs of baby freaking spiders. And you wonder why I haven't found this place yet in my life. My gosh. Anyway, so I do what I always do, and I mind over freaking matter. That is one of the things that I pride myself on being really good at. I pride myself on having the ability to remain calm in stressful situations. I've saved a lot of people's lives, like, not trying to brag, it's just the truth. I've saved 3 or 4 people's lives in like these emergency situations where it required a cool, level head, and I was able to do that, and I'm very proud of my ability to do that. And so in this situation, I called on my inner strength, guys. I went to that place, you know, that place in your brain. And I don't even think that when you're at the place, you consciously choose to go to the place. It just kind of happens to you. You know what I mean? It's like that adrenaline moment. Man, 2 nights now, and the story is still going on. I'm wrapping it up. Don't you worry. Anyway, my flight or fight mechanism mixed with my calm rationality all kicked in all at once. And I decided to stay calm and not get freaked out. And I checked myself before I wrecked myself. And I made sure that I didn't have a stupid amount of spiders on me. And realized that, you know what? They're not poisonous. They're not black widows. They're just some garden spiders or whatever. They're just normal. They're just funky little normal brown little freaking spiders, right? So I took some deep breaths and I said, the only thing I can do is get out of here first, because I can't clean myself off and then walk through a freaking 1,000 more of them. So I just have to trudge it. I just have to Viking myself and trudge through this place and get the heck out of here and then strip down and freaking take a shower when I get home. That's the only way about this. You know what I'm saying? So I, like I said, a deep breath. I found my inner warrior and I started trudging. And so I was starting to feel good, you know? I was starting to feel like things were looking up. I was getting out of here. I was starting to notice some of the areas in which they weren't living, some plants they weren't living on. So I kind of steered towards that kind of stuff. You know, and I started to figure it out. I started to figure out how to get out of this freaking miserable area. Anyway, so another thing starts to happen. Of course, the story is not over. So I start to get this other sensation. This other sensation that I think some of you also might be familiar with. It's like 100 different freaking scary movies all in one, I'm telling you. So I get this feeling like somebody's watching me, right? I get this feeling like there's something. And it was for about 20 minutes. And now I think my original estimation of the distance might be a little bit off. Either that, or maybe it was a rough terrain, it was getting scared of the spiders, who knows, but it was taking me a really long time to get out of this area, and it was well past dark. So at this point, I was relying on my night vision, honest, like literally in full tree cover, full pine trees, like literally like what we got over here. And so this is literally what's inspiring this area, is this story. This area is inspired directly from that story in the landscape here. So I'm walking around, trudging as fast as I can, but it's been a long time and it's dark. And I get this feeling like somebody's watching me, and I've had it for around about 20 minutes, and I'm just suppressing it, I'm ignoring it. Because in my mind, I'm like, I'm in adrenaline mode, I'm in shock, I'm freaked out from these spiders, you know, all the different things are going through my head. So this isn't real, it's not a real feeling, there isn't somebody stalking me, you know what I'm saying? Turns out, there was some kind of reality to that, or maybe it was coincidental, or who knows what it was, but it turns out that there was people very close by. So I'm trying to explain this. It's so the order of events were very hard to remember for me, but I do remember specifically having another one of those clarity moments where the feeling no longer could be contained, and I had to check my surroundings for like the 100th time to make sure that there wasn't anybody around. And that's when I noticed a tarp on the ground. I noticed a tarp, and initially I was like, okay, there's homeless people living out here in the woods, not a big deal. Like, the homeless people in my town are very not dangerous. Just a little tiny backstory just to get you in the mindset of me at the time. I've never been in a situation in my entire life, like 20 years in the town, where I felt afraid for my safety while being alone or something. So it's just not the kind of place where bad stuff happens. Honestly, like, there is not that. There's just not enough people there. It's like, I think there's like 10,000 people approximately at the time in the whole freaking town. So it's just a small little place. I'm not worried about it. I'm not worried about it being some murderous, crazy people. And then I kind of am like starting to look around. I'm starting to notice a little bit more structure stuff. And again, this is dark at this point. So I whip out a lighter from deep within my camping gear and my backpack and my little first aid pouch that I have in the bottom there. And I'm starting to kind of try and look around and make sure I'm not stepping on anything, and kind of starting to turn around. And again, I notice that for the last who knows how long, I've been walking through a campsite. Now, it hasn't just been a campsite. Like, it's not a campsite. It's not a place. This is backwoods. This is next to an old paper mill. This is like off the beaten trail by a half mile. There's no way into here. It's surrounded by a freaking Lord of the Rings style enchanted forest full of spiders. Nobody lives out. Nobody's coming out here. So whatever this little campsite is that I'm seeing is bad news. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is not, even in my small town, this is not somewhere where you'd want to be. And so I start to kind of try and notice more things, kind of like kind of focus into what's going on. And sure enough, there's like a whole pathway system that I just so happen to be along. There's signposts with road names. There's literal roads with literal names in the middle of this foresty, thickety brush. All hand dug out with machetes, right? And these are networking into these tents that are dug under the ground with chimneys, with full-on freaking chimney stacks made with chimney piping and recycled things like pallet houses and old coffee, like, pots that were converted into like boiling things over campfires and cinder blocks. Oh my gosh, guys, it was like, on one hand, it was almost like awe-inspiring, the amount of hand like built structures and stuff in the area. But obviously I was terrified, because like I said, this was a half mile out into the middle of nowhere. These could be some very, very unfriendly people who don't want random, teenage kids walking basically into their secret fort, because now they've got to kill me so nobody else finds out where they live. You know what I'm saying? Oh my gosh, it was a pretty terrifying moment. So again, what I did is I stopped moving. I stopped moving for maybe about a minute. I think I didn't move for maybe about a minute. If you've ever been in a situation like that, you know that there's not much you can do about that. That is your fight or flight responses kicking in. That's what your body does when you're in a shocking situation like that, is you freeze. And it's because your brain's trying to find information. It's trying to find the noise of the predator in the bushes. In this case, I'm trying to listen for people breathing. I'm trying to listen for people talking, moving, breathing. I don't want to be, I hope this camp's abandoned. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really hope this camp's abandoned. It's pitch black at this point, except for my lighter flame. I'm barely surrounding, maybe 6 feet in front of me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm listening, and I'm sitting there for maybe about a minute. I have to guess, if I had to wager a guess. And I finally decided to just walk out of the area because I haven't heard anything in the whole time. So I do. I walk out of the area. I walk over maybe, I mean, maybe in real, like in the Minecraft terms. How about this? We'll walk in the Minecraft distance because this is actually, you know, three feet block right here, a three foot wide block. So I'm walking and I'm walking over just this kind of amazing distance of tents and campsites and stuff. And I finally freaking, it's like this far and I don't hear anything and I don't see anybody moving. I don't see any light sources or anything. I finally got out of it without a sound at all, without any light at all, without any indication that anybody was there. And I had completely forgotten the whole time about the spiders. I had forgotten that I had walked through all of these spiders and that I had decided to myself that I was going to stop cleaning myself off of the spiders. So I finally got back onto the main road. And I finally was like, I finally calmed down. It was the most stressful experience in the recent memories at the time that I could remember. It was just amazing, all of the stressful things all in the thing, all at once. All the things in the thing, yeah. So it was that moment where I was walking down the street, and I looked down, and I was covered in baby spiders in the middle of the night, soaking wet, on the side of the road as a car was rushing by me, splashing water onto my legs and my shoes. And I just thought to myself, you know what? I am a freak badass, right? Like, that was some badass adventuring. You know what I'm saying? That was the only thing I could take away from that moment, is I just felt so happy with myself that I was able to, like, in a 4 mile wide island of a town that's surrounded in three sides by water, I was able to simultaneously be lost, scared, wet, cold, dark, covered in baby spiders in the middle of a potentially murderous tribe of homeless encampment people in my hometown. I don't know, guys. That was just, it was one of those experiences that just sticks with you. You know what I'm saying? Those moments of your life that stick in your brain as photographic. And that image of me on the side of the road, covered in these baby spiders. I picked up a fir branch from the gutter that was all muddy. And I brushed myself off with this muddy fir branch. There's baby spiders crushed all over my pant legs and falling onto the ground. And it's just moments like that where I'll just appreciate my adventurous nature and how I don't think I'm ever going to change in that situation, in that sense. I don't think I'll ever choose not to take the shortcut. If I ever get the opportunity, I freaking take the opportunity, because you know what? Without putting yourself in those uncomfortable situations, you're never going to have a good story to tell. And I think that is kind of like the moral here of the story and of the episode. So thank you guys so much for coming to hang out with me and listen to me talk about stuff and hanging out and listen to my story. Let me know if you liked it. Let me know if you had any similar experiences where you were lost and you realized all of a sudden where you were and the adrenaline sunk in and you had to act. So let me know down in the comments. I ran out of time, obviously, I'm pretty sure, for the day, so I'm going to call it here. Let's take a sleep job real quick and we'll do a little cruise by while I let you roll out. Look at what we just did today, and I'll show you how I'm expanding the area. So let me know if you liked it, obviously, with a like rating if you did, and if you disliked it, let me know why you did. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Have a really good day. Bye-bye.